Good morning, students. Today we will see about the 555 type of ICs. In our previous lectures, we have seen about the 741 operational amplifier ICs. So again, we will slightly revise here. What about the 555 type of ICs? So here, first of all, we will see that what is the basically ICs. So basically, ICs is a very compact circuitry designing that is built up on a single chip. So if you are talking about the 555 timer ICs, so that ICs is basically a linear ICs. So what about the linear ICs? So that is basically, if you are talking about the linear ICs, so we can use in linear ICs external components. Okay, so this type of ICs can be used for thousands of applications. So presently, these 555 timer ICs is useful for thousands of applications because we can externally add some extra component and we can change the use of that particular 555 timer ICs to a different uses. So that is the basic feature of our 555 timer ICs, is that it is a basically linear ICs and we can also introduce some external components. So now we will see that how we will configure a standard 555 timer IC. It will work as a very important functions of such as it is a monostable mode, bistable mode and square wave oscillator in a stable mode. So these are the three major configurations of our 555 timer IC in which this IC works, and it is very useful for our different applications. So first of all, basic description of our 555 timer ICs, first of all we will see, and after then one by one we will discuss the different configurations in which 555 timer ICs are useful. If we have seen about the internal diagram of our 555 timer IC, so what we have to see that there are at least 25 transistors, 2 diodes and 15 resistors. Means this is a very vast electronic circuit. So how you can these circuits can be handled and controlled? So that is basically we will see about the, instead of using that so much lengthy circuits, we will just represent our 555 timer ICs as a simple block diagram. And these all circuits, 25 transistors, 2 diodes and 15 resistors, are compactly built up in a very small chip. So that is the basically advantage of our making the ICs integrated circuit. So here we will not much focus on the how we will make an integrated circuit. That is a separate topic for discussions. But we can see that how 25 transistor, 2 diodes and 15 resistors complicated circuit can be built up in a 8 pin connection simple chip of our electronics circuit. So that is so presently we will discuss about in terms of block diagram for your simplest explanation. So this is, you can see the very simple diagram of our 555 IC. So in this diagram we will see that there is a 2 comparators. So that is basically a 741 operational amplifier. So as we have seen in our previous lecture, that 741 operational amplifier, it is also work as a comparator. So here we will see what is the role of our comparator in this 555 timer ICs. There is a flip-flop. We have also studied about the flip-flop, role of flip-flop. We have also a resistors, and there is a resistive network. So that is whole. So there are, so these terminals are, so one by one we will discuss the parts and explain how these 555 timer IC, because this IC is very useful in our electronic circuitry. So you can see this is a resistive circuit and we are using the 5K, 5K, 3 5K resistances. We can also use the threshold value. There is a trigger, so the threshold voltage is applied to the pin number 6. We have also take the reference voltage, and that reference voltage is related to the VCC. So 2/3 part of VCC is take as a reference voltage for one comparator in the negative terminal or inverting input, and again 1/3 VCC is taken as a non-inverting input of the second comparator. So now one by one we will start from our discussions. And that is again a, if you are not if you are, this is the basically block diagram and this is the simple pin diagram of our 555 timer IC. So here we will see that what will happen. This is basically a 8 pin diagram in which we are not using the 8 pins. So you can see here what is the basically 8 and 4. These are pin number 4 is a reset terminal and pin number 8 is the supply terminal. So when our reset terminal is presently not working, so then we have connect these terminal, reset terminal, to the plus VCC supply. In pin number 7, there is a discharge input. We will see in further slides. Threshold voltage, what about the threshold voltage? R1 and R2 resistances you have to give, and C1 is the capacitor. So basically, these are the basic diagram of our stable configurations. So now we will switch to the, what will happen? The voltage divider. What is the role of our voltage divider? And that is consist of the three identical 5 kilo ohm resistors, which create, so by using these voltage resistor circuit, what will happen there? How we can divide our voltage? So that is basically these values are, since these are the three equal values, 5 kilo ohm resistors, so we can generate two reference voltage, 1/3 of VCC and 2/3 of VCC of the supply voltage. And the range of that is the basically 5 to 15 volt. So we can also use in this part. Now what will happen? We have seen the two comparators as I have to show you in the basic block diagram. So what is the role of our comparator? Comparator will be, what is the role of comparator? It will compare two analog inputs at its positive and negative input terminal. So what about the positive, non-inverting and inverting input terminal? So that is a basic function of our comparator, compare the two analog signals. If input voltage at the positive terminal is higher, so what will happen here? If input voltage, what you have to apply your input voltage at the positive terminal, and it is higher than the input voltage at the negative terminal, if we are talking about the comparator 1. So what will be the output? So at that particular point, if the positive terminal is higher than the negative terminal, so your output of comparator will be high. Vice versa, reverse, if voltage at the negative terminal is higher than the voltage at the positive terminal, so output of your comparator will be zero. So we will see these type of phenomena in our further configuration. Suppose first comparator, so that is basically negative input terminal is connected to the 2/3 reference voltage at the voltage divider and external control pins is, while the positive input terminal to the external threshold pin. So these are connected such a way. Other hand, when we are talking about the second comparator, so in the second comparator, what will happen there? Negative input terminal is connected to the trigger and positive terminal is connected to the 1/3 of VCC. So that is a reference voltage. Means in comparator 1, reference signal is connected to the negative input terminal, and in comparator number 2, what will happen here? Reference signals, that is equal to 1/3 VCC, that is connected to the positive pin number. So what will happen here? So we will again see. So output of the flip-flop is also disconnected to a transistor that disconnects the discharge pin to the ground. So that is basically a transistor that is a discharge from where we can connect the discharge pin, and that will be connected to the, so output of flip-flop. So what type of output we are getting from our flip-flop? And output of flip-flop is depend on the input, SR input of our flip-flop. And what is the SNR input? SNR input is the output of our operational amplifier. So basically what we have to done, which type of comparator is giving which type of signal. So according to that value, our flip-flop will be working, and according to working of flip-flop, our transistor that connects to the discharge pin, it will either connected to the flip-flop or it will disconnected from that particular point. So this is the point we have to remember. Again, we will see this type of diagram. So I think there is no need to revise, otherwise I will again want to show you that particular block diagram. So using three pins, so we have generally, if we are talking about the three pins, so we have to also see the description, trigger, threshold and control. So we can control the output of two comparator, Okay, so what type of pins are responsible for controlling the output of our comparators? Trigger, threshold, and control signals are responsible for controlling the output of our two comparators. Which are so what will happen where these output of two comparators are goes on? Output of our comparators are connected to the R and S inputs of the flip flop. So this is the basic. And flip flop will be output 1 when R is 0, S is 1. Because when S is 1, flip flop will be set. Vice versa will be when R is 1, flip flop will be reset. And flip flop will be reset means output of flip flop will be 0. So this is the working condition. So we are study about the different parts. And then we can again accumulate all things in a single block diagram. So additional flip flop can be reset. Okay, so what will happen? First of all, you have to reset. So flip-flop can be reset. So how you can reset your flip-flop? External pin, that is called as a reset, which can override the two inputs. Override the two inputs mean what type of inputs you are giving to the S and R terminal, it doesn't matter. If reset terminal is set, means your flip-flop will be reset. Okay, and that entire timer at any time. So you can reset your flip-flop at the particular any time. So that is basically, so we will again want to show you the basic diagram that is we have in our in this diagram. And that diagram. Okay, there is slight disturbances. Just see in this part. I'm again what I have told you, this is the comparators. That output of comparator is connected to SNR, okay? The threshold, trigger, and control voltage. So you can give the control voltage directly to the 2/3 VCC terminal. So this basic part, these three are responsible for controlling the output. So these are our the control signals which can control. Now you can see here. So either you can controlling your output voltage, so you can give here the control voltage. If you are not giving here, then threshold voltage or trigger voltage. Okay, so you can control output. These are the output terminals. These are the reset. If you want to reset your flip-flop, what type of inputs you are giving to the SNR doesn't matter. It will be directly reset your flip-flop. And when your flip-flop will be reset, your output will be low. And according to that, it will be work out. So at that particular time, your transistor is connected to the discharge terminal. Okay. So this is our the very basic part of our 555 timer. Now we will see the different configurations in which our 555 timer is working. So that overall working is same. So we will see how our flip-flops will work out. So just we have to move to the forward where I have to show. This is the pin diagram. So you, before starting the configurations, there is again a pin diagram connection. So what about the pin diagram? Since you complete 25 transistor, 2 op-amp, 2 diodes, all these functions are accumulated in a single chip. So you can see here, this chip is very small chip. 555 IC is very small IC. So and that small ICs can handle the large number of applications. So you can see here. So this is the basically 8-pin ICs, okay? So 8-pin ICs, so that is first pin number is indicated as a ground. Second pin number is trigger as used for triggering output. Pin number third is give the output. Fourth number pin is used for reset. Again, fifth is used for controlling the output signal. Sixth is the threshold discharge. So these are the 8 terminals in which all these signals are you can give. Means there is no you can't see any type of circuitry. You have only the pins available at their panels, and you can only give the signals to these particular pins, and then according to that you can work out. So this is a very simple ICs of our linear ICs, analog ICs. So just I have to told you, pin number one is ground, pin number two is triggered, so that is called as a TRI. So what will happens in low voltage applied to the trigger input causes the output to go high. Means what will happen if you have to, what is the trigger? Okay, basically there is a trigger terminal and that is connected to the operational amplifier. So if you have applying the low voltage at that particular terminal, so what will happen? Your output will be go high and output will remain high. Tab tak high rahega until a high voltage is applied to the threshold input. Means there are two terminals. In one op amp is connected with the trigger input. That is the reference supply is 1/3 VCC and your what will happens there? Another pin number 6 that is connected to the threshold input, okay, and that is the comparative to the 2/3 VCC. So now what will happens here? Ki your low voltage applied, jab aapka low voltage applied, we apply the low voltage to the trigger terminal, your output signal may be high. So that is the same thing what we have to explain. Now what about the pin number 3? So pin number 3 is the output low state, the output will be 0 volt, and if you have receiving the high output, means your output will be 1.7 volt lower than the supply voltage, what type of supply you are using. What about the reset terminal? Low voltage on reset terminal applied pin will be causes the output to go low. So at that, when you have given the low voltage to your reset terminal, that particular value, then it will be go to low, and this input should remain connected to the VCC when not used. So we have also seen in our pin number 8 and pin number 4, we have to show you in our block diagram. So that particular point, pin number 8 and pin number 4 is internally connected or shorted, because when you are not working, you are not using the reset terminal, that terminal should be connected to the VCC. Okay, so because reset pin will cause the output go low, because that reset pin is active low signal. Means if any type of low voltage less than 0.7 volt applied to the reset pin, it will be reset the all 555 timer IC. So it is a very risky. So always you have to put your reset pin to the plus VCC supply, because if it will receive any low signal, your flip-flop or 555 timer will be reset. So for precautionary point of view, we will connect our pin number 4 in ordinary conditions, it will connect it to the supply voltage. Now what about the control voltage? We have to also see. So with help of control voltage, the threshold voltage through the control input, okay? So basically internally, jo 2/3 VCC supply is controlled by using this pin number 5 control voltage. So directly you cannot change threshold voltage. By using the control signals, threshold voltage can be changed. Now you can vary it from 45% to 90% of the supply voltage, and this enables you to vary the length of output pulse. Means if you are known to change the length of your output pulses in monostable mode, your output frequency which is calculated in a stable mode, so that is can be possible with help of your control voltage. And when not in use, so what is the when your this control signal is not in use, so what you have to done, you have to recommend it that this input to be connected to the ground via 0.01 microfarad capacitor. So by using a capacitor, you can connect this terminal to the ground terminal, okay, when we are not in working conditions. So it is the different pins, but this is the control voltage. So we can, how we can change the threshold voltage by using the control signals. And how you can change your control voltage? So you can vary your control voltage from 45% to 90% of the supply voltage. And now this enables you to vary the length of output pulse in monostable mode. So if you are wanting to change your length of pulses, so it will be changed by using the control signals. So it is a very easy for us. And output frequency will be also changed in a stable mode configurations. So control voltage is a very important role in our 555 timer. Now pin number 6, that is the threshold. In both the stable and monostable mode, the voltage across the timing capacitor is monitored through the threshold input. When voltage at this input rises above the threshold value, the output will go from high to low. Means what will happen? This voltage is monitored, okay? So what is our voltage across the timing capacitor? So these voltage is monitored by the threshold input, okay? Or when these voltage are exceed above the threshold value, when you are applying any type of signals and that will be exceed to the threshold value, the output will be go from high to low. Pin number 7 is the discharge. When the voltage across the timing capacitor exceed the threshold value, timing capacitor is discharged through this input. There is also another option for discharging the capacitor. Now pin number 8, supply voltage. So that is between the plus 5 volt to plus 15 volt supply, and RC timing interval will not vary much over the supply voltage range. So what is the basically the relation? We are also using a capacitor in our circuitry part, and we are also using the resistor circuit in our system. So that RC timing interval, what type of RC timing interval will not vary much over the supply voltage range. So this is a limitations. Either it will be working in the stable mode or it will be working in the monostable mode. So this is a basic limitations. Now we have to work out in the monostable mode. So this is the 555 timer monostable mode. So now what will happen there? There is a slight change. Okay. All pin numbers are same. There is a discharge, there is a threshold, okay, there is a trigger input, there is a again the reference signal, and this is the trigger signals, okay, and these are resistance R2, there is switch S1, and again there is a ground terminal, there is a capacitor C1, and this is the capacitor R1 and C1. How is the role of R1 and C1? So this is our monostable mode operations, and now we can see this one. This is the true operational amplifier. This is a flip-flop. This is the output stage. So this it work. So you have to see how it will work. So in a further slide, this is a pin number 5. That is the control signals. Pin number 4, that is a reset. Okay. So we will see how it monostable mode. Okay. So it will monostable mode means it will exist only in, it will remain high, and after some time period, it will goes to the low state. Means only a certain time duration it will remain in the high state. So this is a basically the, we can see here, this is basically 555 timer diagram. Okay, pin numbers according to pin, there is a basically block diagram, and it same thing is here. It is based on the 555 IC. R1 and C1, these are the resist external components which have to apply in our IC. That is basically a linear IC, and we are, there is not, now you are not seeing any type of comparator, flip-flop, so that is basically a chip, okay? And these, how we can connect this chip and how we can give the input. So there is a output square pulse, you have to trigger, there is a push button for triggering. Once you have to trigger, your output will go from low to high, and after some time period, automatically it will return back to the low, okay? And again, when you trigger, then your output will go high. So that is the range ki when your 555 timer is work only in monostable mode. So what about the monostable mode? So monostable mode, it is work on only single mode. When you have to trigger, so that there is a frequency, you have to trigger many times, then you can achieve the waveform. So this is according to your applications. You have to once start any device, so you have once trigger, your output will be received, and you can execute any type of operations. So that is a control voltage, and that is connected to capacitor, through capacitor to the ground. So that are the things what we have to discuss in our previous lecture. So basically trigger input is held high by connecting to the VCC through a resistor. So once you have to trigger, ek bar you have to give the high signal, means because it is, and then it is connected to the VCC, as we have told you. That means that trigger comparator will output zero. Okay, so comparator in which trigger will connected, that will output zero to the S input of the flip-flop. Means in S terminal, we are getting the zero signal. So on the other hand, threshold in is low, and that makes the threshold comparator zero as well. So at that particular, that will be the zero, and threshold pin is actually low because Q bar output of the flip flop is high. So Q bar is 1, so Q is automatically low, and which keeps the discharge transistor active. So what will happen here? Discharge transistor is active, and voltage coming from source is going to the ground through this transistors. So that is the basic theory part. Now, in order to press the 555 timer output state to high, we need to press the trigger on. Once you have to trigger the push button, your output across the 555 timer will be high. So that will ground the trigger pin, or input state will be zero. So now what will happen? That will, so at that particular, when you push that your trigger button, it will goes to the high, and after then you will ground the trigger pin, or input state will be this time zero. So comparator will output one and S input of the flip-flop. Or ye jo one hai, that is give to the S input. So there is also a flip-flop. You have to see in our diagram, there is a basically comparator circuit. So when S will be, so will output one to the S. So if you are giving the output one to the S, so now what will happen? Your output is low and 555 timer output will be high, because S is one. So what will happen here? S is one, so your output of flip-flop will be also one. At the same time, we can notice that discharge transistor is turned off. So jaise your output will be high, discharge transistor is off. And so now the capacitor C1 will start charging through the resistance R1. So now what will happen here? Charging of capacitor will be started. So that is all working processes. Now timer will remain in this state how many times, how much time, until voltage across the capacitor reaches to the 2/3 volt of this, because in comparator 1, now what will happen there? In comparator 1, there is a comparison between reference voltage and what type of signals you have to apply. So here what will happen? First comparator, there is a reference voltage of 2/3 VCC. So this will remain in this state until jab tak nahi your capacitor will be charged up to the 2/3 of VCC. So till time your capacitor will be charges. So in that case, threshold input voltage will be higher and comparator will be, output will be 1, and it will be given to the R. So because this output of this comparator will be, output of this comparator will be connected to the R input of the flip-flop. So this will bring the circuit to the again in zero state. And Q bar output will again become high, so which will activate the discharge transistor, because discharge transistor is connected to the Q bar output terminal. So your discharge transistor is on, and as well as make the IC output. So as the discharge transistor is on, your output will be low again. So again, we will discuss how many times your, so just you can see here, this is a trigger input, just you can see. So now trigger input, you can, once triggered, since your trigger input is active low, then you have to give the zero signal to the trigger terminal. At that instant, your charging of capacitor will be started, and how much time it will be started, it is depend that till now your voltage across the capacitor will be 2/3 of VCC. So that time period your capacitor will be charges, and when it will be charges, after then it will be slightly discharges through the transistor. So you have to also a transistor. So after this period, this is the active low, and again this is the capacitor voltage, monostable state. So T, what is the value of T? Means how much time duration. So this is the T, 1.1 into C1 and R1. So that is a basically time period. You can see here 1.1 into C1 and R1. So this is the time period T. So T is equal to 1.1 into C1 R1. So what is the C1? C1 is a capacitor that is connected in the in series with the CR1. So R1, C1. So that is a basically how much time period your output will be high. That depends on the value of R1 and C1. So that is the basic theme of our monostable output. Means if how may means that is a basically how many time period you want to activate or put your output of your flip flop high. So that is a basic reason. When your output of flip-flop will be high, so what type of devices are connected to that particular device, it will be the on period. And these on period can be controlled by external component, that is the R1 and C1. So by help of external component R1 and C1, we can control the time period of monostable output state. So this is the waveforms. Once you have triggered, your system will be start to working. And after some time period, so there is not a controlling of output, that is the 1.1 R1 C1, that particular time period, your output will be again to the zero state or low state. So that is the same thing what we have to told you, okay, how much time it will be high and how much time. So you can calculate by using this formula. Now that is the second mode. First mode is the monostable mode, and now we can see the stable mode. So what about the stable state? Okay, so there is again a that is also 555 timer, and in this stable mode it is called as a free running multivibrator. There is no controlling, it will automatically run to the between these two levels. So here we can see what type of two layers we are using here. So that is basically depend on the how the 555 timer works in a stable mode. So it does a stable. What about the and continuously switches between high and low. So that is basically continuously running stage. Just see here. You can see here there is a resistance, again an extra resistance, that is the discharge resistance R1, R2 and C1. Okay, in our previous diagram we have seen only the R1 and C1, but in this diagram we have also uses the resistance R2. Okay, and remaining is same. Pin number 5 is represent to the control voltage, pin number represent to the reset terminal, and at normal terminal or when it is not working the reset terminal, it is connected to the plus VCC supply. And this is a discharge transistor, and that is connected through the pin number 7. So what will happen here? Here is only one state. So only two resistor and capacitor, trigger and threshold pins are connected to each other, so that there is not any external trigger pulses required. The voltage source will start charging the capacitor R1 and R2. So there are two resistive resistance that is used for charging the capacitor. While charging the capacitor, charging the trigger comparator, will output will be 1, because input voltage at the trigger pin is still lower than 1/3 of supply voltage. So you have to know when your output will be high. So in which terminal the comparator which is having in below, that is basically depend on the reference signal is 1/3 of VCC. So at that particular time period, you will compare your signal with the 1/3 of VCC. What type of signals trigger in comparator will output 1? Trigger pin is still lower. That means that Q bar output, if Q is 1, so what will happen Q bar, because Q bar is the reverse of Q. So Q bar output is 0 and the discharge transistor is closed. So at this time the output of 555 timer is high. So that is the same thing how you can compare one's voltage across capacitor. So we have two reference points, 1/3 VCC and 2/3 VCC. So now what will happen? Once voltage across the capacitor, reaches to the 1/3 of supply voltage, trigger. So what is the which comparator? Trigger comparator will output 0. But at this point, that won't do any changes as both S and R will be inputs are 0. So we can also see in our flip-flop chapters, when S and R both are 0, so there is no change, and whatever the previous value, that value will be reflected in the flip-flop. So the voltage across capacitor will keep rising, and now once it reaches to 2/3 of the supply voltage, the threshold comparator will output 1 to the R. So there is a R. Again, what type of comparator are connected to the R, that will be 1, and according to that your flip-flop will be reset. And this will activate the charging discharging. So now what will happen when it will be reset? It will activate the discharging transistor, and When you activate the discharging transistor, now the capacitor will start discharging through these resistors and transistor. So at this moment, output of 555 timer is low. So at this particular time, its output will be again low. So you can see here, once your capacitor will be charged, 2/3 VCC, capacitor voltage. Now again in next, it will be slightly discharges, again charges, discharges. So that is the basically shape of your capacitor voltage. And according to that, when it is charges, you will receive a square pulse. When it is discharges, low, high, low, high. So that is the output voltage. So that the stable mode conditions, so that will be running, free running means it will be charges to the 2/3 VCC, again discharges to the 1/3 VCC. When there is again comparison between 1/3 VCC and triggered, and then again that will trigger to the flip-flops in again high, again low, again high. So this process will be repeated. So this is generally called as a free running multivibrators. Once you have to start your function, it will be continuously running without the help of any external devices. And what time duration it will be high, your output will be high. You can see right high, falling is there is no signal. So only you have a signal during the rising edge. So I think this diagram is clear to you. So while discharging, voltage across capacitor starts to decline. Okay, so discharging starts to jati, then threshold comparator right way starts to output zero, and which actually doesn't do any changes as now both R and S inputs are zero. So if both the inputs are zero, there is no change. But once voltage across the capacitor drops to 1/3 of the supply voltage, when your voltage will be reduced 1/3 of power supply, the trigger comparator will output 1. So at that point, the comparator where trigger pin is connected, that will be the 1 output. So this will turn off the discharge. So now what will happen here? Turn off the discharge capacitor and capacitor will start to the charge again. So again your capacitor will be charging. So this charging, discharging phenomena will be repeated. So that is the same thing. And we can generate the square wave by using this charging and discharging phenomena. Now we can calculate the time the output is high and low during the formula. So you can also, high time depends on the resistance of both R1 and R2 as well as capacitance of resistance. And on the other hand, what will happens means we have to see 1.1 R1 C1. So what is, in which factor our high output depends? Our high output depends on the R1 and R2. And what will happens, and your low output will depend only the resistance of R2 and the capacitance of capacitor. So there is only the two formulas. So if we sum the high and low states, we will get the period of one cycle. Okay, so here we can see here. On the other hand, the frequencies, how many times, so you can also calculate. So on and off period will determine the one cycles of your output signal, and by using this output signal, how many number of output signals will be added together, and it will be, and now we can calculate the frequency of that particular cycles. On the other hand, frequency is how many times this happens in 1 second. So if you are calculating the number of cycles in 1 second, so that is called as a frequency. So you can also calculate the frequency by using this form. Now some modifications in this circuit: change the R2 resistor with variable resistance, so we can instantly control the frequency and duty cycle. So what about the duty cycle? Basically duty cycle is T on upon total time period. So if you have to calculate the on period and off period, so by controlling the change in resistance value, you can also change the voltage drop across. And by using this voltage drop across R2, you can use the basically control the frequency and duty cycles of our square waveforms. Now last we will see the 555 timer in bistable mode. Okay, so what about the bistable? That is basically there are two state. Okay, so now let's make an again we will take the 555 timer, and that purpose we need two external. So now you can, there is slightly change, just we can see now here R1 and R2, only two resistances are there. That is this one, this divider network. This is the op amp, this is the working conditions, and this is the output taken across the circuit. That is this pin number 3. So that is basically bistable state. So other once again, if you have to start your functioning, you have to press the trigger button. The state of the trigger input will become low, so the comparator output will be high, and that will make the flip flop. If your output is high, so that way flip flop will be go low because it is connected to the R, and output stage will invert this, and final we can reach to the output high value. So that is bistable. Output will remain high even when the trigger sub push button is not moved, because in this case flip flop inputs R and S. So now here is again thing, here we want to push to, again I am told you ki output will remain high even when trigger not pushed. Once you have triggered your input, then you have to not repeat to it again. In that case flip flop input R and S will be zero, so it will again reset and flip flop will change the previous state. So for making the output low, we need press the reset button, and which resets the flip flop and the entire IC. So this is the reason how our system will work out. So you can see the waveforms here. This is the triggering. Once you have to start the triggering, now what will happen? There is no reset state. It will be the reset state, and we have also provided you the, so these are the bistable output circuits. So this is only you can control the on and off time period, and by controlling the on and off time period, you can control the duty cycles, you can control the, you can calculate the time period, and you can calculate the frequency of that particular signals in bistable output. So now we will again discuss about the applications of our 555 timer IC. So there are the 555 timer ICs in used in thousands of applications, and so many our lab projects and different major projects are uses the 555 timer IC for different applications. So first of all, we will see the pulse width modulation, or PPM, pulse position modulation. So that is basically a modulation system, and we can also use for making the generator or modulator of this system by using the 555 timer IC. Duty cycle oscillator, so it is also work as a duty cycles. If you want to change your duty cycles, you can easily change your duty cycle by using this type of oscillators. Lamp dimmer to provide the accurate time delay, so it is also useful as a flip-flop element. Digital logic probes, okay, so there is a digital logic probes, so there we can also use the 555 timer in our digital probes. Latest we are using analog frequency meter, and that is a timer applications. So as we have to see in that 555 timer in three configurations: mono stable, stable and bistable. So if you are talking about the mono stable, so what is the difference between mono stable? In mono stable state, a particular time period our output of output of our flip flop is high, so according to that output of our 555 is high, okay, and after certain time period it will be go to the basically lowest. So what amount duration it will be the high, so that is equal to 1.1 RC. so that is a basically, when we are talking about the stable multivibrator, that is also called as a free running multivibrators, and that is also switched between the two reference voltage, 2/3 VCC to 1/3 VCC. So once your capacitor will be start charges, so it will charge to the 2/3 VCC, it will again start and it will discharges to the transistors, and again it will charge to the 1/3 VCC. So that is the part it will go to the 2/3 VCC and discharge to the up to the 1/3 VCC. And when 1/3 VCC comes, it will compare to the reference voltage, and according to output of op-amp, it will again charges and discharges. So we can see it, that is, it is a free running multivibrator. After charging and discharging, process will be continued. In that, and in last stage is the our bistable stage. So in that bistable stage, you can see here, we can control the on and off time period, and by using or controlling the our on and off time period, now what will happens on and off, if you are controlling the on and off time periods, you can also control the duty cycles, and you can also calculate the frequency of that particular bistable state. So this is the basic applications where we are using our 555 timer ICs. Now we will again see here, what is the function of the comparators in 555 timer IC? So there we can, what type of functioning we have to done. So these are some objective questions based on what we have to take in this lecture. So what is the time period of monostable? So what is the monostable multivibrators? Who will determine the time period, or in which component it will, which component is responsible for determining the time period of a monostable multivibrator? That is a basically functional diagram of 555 timer IC, consists of the two comparators. That is, we can know nothing else. What type of waveforms, what is the shape of our waveform which is generated by 555 timer ICs? So it is also a good question. So which type of waveforms we are generating? 555 timer IC is a how many pin devices? So that is basically you have to know how many pins are useful for working in our 555 timer IC. So 555 timer IC is also good name. So what, why it is called as a 555? Because 3 5k 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 resistors are used as a divider network. How can a monostable multivibrator be modified into a linear ramp generator? So you can also know how you can modify your monostable multivibrators. And we can also see our applications in a monostable multivibrator. So how you can control, what is the basic use of our many monostable? So first of all, you have to remember how your timer is working in monostable operations, and what is the component which is responsible for the output waveforms of our monostable multivibrator. So we have to know there is a certain time period T that is equal to 1.1 R1 and C1. So R and C components are responsible for our basic working of 555 timer. So you can decide by changing the values of components, we can also increase the time period of high time period of our monostable application. So you have to know what about the monostable operations, what will happen in a stable operation, and what will happens in bistable operations. Okay, so there is a three parameters. If you are talking about the stable mode, there is a free running, means your multi vibrators or 555 ICs are regularly charging and discharging. Action of that, it will continuously on off, and that is called as a free running multi vibrators. Now same thing is happens here. When we are working on the bistable, so there are two stable states. So there is also by comparative, it will be the on time and there will be the off time. And by using that particular, we can show that. So if you have to given the value of R, if you have to given the value of time delay, what type of time T delay provided by the monostable multivibrators, you can calculate the value of C. So that is a nothing else, very easy questions, and you can put your values and you can see this results. Okay, what type of value you have to select for providing the time delay, because monostable multivibrator is also used for providing the time delay. So I think it will be clear to you. It will, all questionnaires we have to done. There is again a question, last question, how you can overcome mistriggering. So we have to also told you what is the role of mistriggering, how we can connect our trigger input terminals. You know, it is basically generally trigger terminal is connected to the, how it is connected. Okay, it is connected to a either integrator, either differentiator, either diode. So this is the reason. So if you know the basic concept behind this, you can be comfortable for calculating all these values. So this is all the questions. So this is a 555 timer, is a very important device. We can calculate, we can control our output waveforms. It is also a square wave generator. So if you are want to design a function generator, if you want to design a square wave generator, we can use this type of timer ICs. And so many applications, so many projects work, we are using this type of IC. It is a very small chip and it will contain the 25 transistors, 2 diodes and flip-flops, so many things. So it is a very, very useful device in our. So, and since it is a linear circuits and its inputs are basically based on our analog inputs. Okay, so this is a basic summary and important characteristics of our 555 timer ICs. So now it's okay. And now thank you.